most of the therapies that we use for people who have group 1 pulmonary arterial hypertension come in tablet form. And there's now three different drug classes available, and you may be on three different types of medications through tablets. Sometimes we'll use medications that are nebulized, or if you have more advanced or severe disease, the doctor may recommend using the most powerful treatments that are administered continuously through a drip. And we train you to use the special pump. And even though it sounds scary and difficult, most people manage very, very well with a little line that's in permanently, and then they administer a medication through a pump. If you have other types of pulmonary hypertension, such as severe lung disease, or your pulmonary hypertension is associated with low oxygen levels, your doctors may also recommend that you're on long-term home oxygen. Some people might have problems like sleep apnea, and it's very important to be optimized on a sleep apnea machine called CPAP, because that can also drive up pulmonary pressures. In people who have other types of heart diseases, it's also important that those conditions are optimized, such as controlling atrial fibrillation and optimizing your fluid balance using medications such as diuretics to help bring the pressures down in the heart as well. So originally, in the early days of pulmonary hypertension medications, we didn't have very many options. And in the past 10 years or so, the landscape has really exploded, and we have many more drugs available to us. And more recently, several trials have demonstrated that being on more than one drug is much more effective. And we recognize now that the earlier that we get our pulmonary hypertension patients on multiple drug therapies, the better they do. That reduces the chance for disease progression, for ending up getting sick, and it reduces the risk for needing transplantation or passing away. So in most circumstances now, people with pulmonary arterial hypertension that's attributed to idiopathic pulmonary hypertension, connective tissue disease, that kind of pulmonary hypertension, we usually plan to have you on more than one drug up front or very early on in the time that we start drug treatment. Sometimes if you're frail or have other health conditions or have very mild disease, we may just introduce one drug, but we have a very, very low threshold now for having people on two. If we don't see a really good response to therapy and an improvement in your walking distances and heart function and blood tests, we now even have a third tablet that we would consider introducing quite quickly. So some people will be on three different types of tablets. If we feel that you're still quite high risk, there's also a drip medication that we know is really the most powerful therapy. So sometimes your doctors may feel that you're safest, not just on tablets, but also having a continuous medication through the drip as well.